MHU keeps me close to home, and there's tons to do in the mountains.
Over 60 courses of study, small class settings, a breathtaking campus. These are just a few examples of how MHU can help you start moving your mountain. Visit us today at mhu.edu. Mars Hill University, education that moves mountains.
We don't always agree who to pull for on game day, but we all can agree that litter is bad for North Carolina.
I just did not have a lot of stability.
I was facing foreclosure.
Not working at all, didn't have any money.
I could not go to school and work, so I found Mars Hill.
The experience here has been so wonderful.
It's been amazing.
I was able to have the full-time hours without the full-time load.
They are just incredibly supportive.
And Mars Hill's very affordable.
Mars Hill University Adult and Graduate Studies, education that moves mountains.
I will be the first in my family to graduate with my bachelor's degree.
Here to discuss so-called flying cost.
Helping you move your mountain.
Mars Hill University gives me plenty of degrees to choose from.
At MHU, I get the attention I deserve.
MHU keeps me close to home, and there's tons to do in the mountains.
Over 60 courses of study, small class settings, a breathtaking campus. These are just a few examples of how MHU can help you start moving your mountain. Visit us today at mhu.edu. Mars Hill University, education that moves mountains.
We don't always agree who to pull for on game day, But we all can agree that litter is bad for North Carolina.
Thank you. Thank you. Students and faculty, thank you for coming together through these hard times this year. But it would not have been possible without the support of our athletic trainers and coaches. To our athletic trainers, thank you for being there for us on and off the field. We are so grateful for your hard work and dedication to us and our team. We truly would not be able to do it without you. To our coaches, we are thankful to have you leading our team. At this time, we would like to recognize you on stage. Will the staff representatives presenting the Paper Plate Awards and the coach they are honoring please come to the stage?
Thank you. My name's Megan Benetton, and we are presenting Coach Alex Griggs with Most Improved Coach.
MVP of Yoga Pants Award. Good evening, students and staff. My name is Raymond Brooks, and I play martial arts. I'm going to be presenting this award for the quietest coach of the year for Jackson Work.
University Athletics all season long, as well as our Lions Athletic Club Booster Club. And now, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, would you please welcome to the field our very own championship Marshall X team and Bailey Mountain Clarkies.
Thank you.
Please welcome to the stage to present the winner of the Team Highest GPA Award, Virginia Joy and Brayden Hoskins.
The winner of Team Highest GPA goes to...
Things can get a little bit crazy. This award recognizes an individual that has gone above and beyond during their 4 years at Mars Hill and has racked up 1,206.25 hours serving the local community.
The winner of this year's Individual Community Service Award is...
Sarah Bolden.
The next set of awards aim to people who work behind the scenes to ensure that athletics run smoothly. First up, the Faculty Staff Supporter of the Year Award recognizes that staff member who supports our students and student athletic program. Here to present the award, Brayden Hoskins and Morgan Hall.
The winner of the Faculty Staff Supporter of the Year Award goes to
Cindy Witt.
All sports here at the university. To present the award, Virginia Joy and Dalton Davidson.
And the winner of Athletic Trainer of the Year goes to Sue
Taylor! Others, on the other hand,
honestly say I had no clue. Believe it or not, I was actually one of those as well. I had no idea what I wanted to do at all. So,
leading in, yes, go
ahead. Is this off? No. Okay. So, leading into my second semester of my senior year, I'd gotten a major in religion and was planning on going into seminary following graduation. And started interning for the strength and conditioning staff there. And at the same time that I was about to start seminary school, was offered an opportunity to go coach at a Division I Big Ten program. Really prayed a lot about it. I really didn't know what I wanted to do, but what it came down to in point was which of these allowed me the best opportunity to help people, in which I decided to go strength and conditioning. Ever since then, I've had a phenomenal opportunity to coach all around the world. And when I say this, I sincerely mean it. Marcell University is the most special place in the entire world. I mean that from the culture that is already here. I mean that from these bugs that are killing me right now. Although we're on third, I've asked like 50 people here before this, why are bugs on third? It's not even real grass. Back to the actual story. Athletes, what's my favorite saying? Say it again, that was weird.
You better love it.
When I went on to the Division I to coach, we had all the resources in the entire world. We had two 10,000 square foot facilities for our department alone. We had exercise physiologists, exercise nutritionists. We had all these different resources. Shortly after my stay in there, I went to a smaller D2 university in Georgia. Went from two 10,000 square foot facilities to a 400 square foot closet in a basement with six racks and 22 teams. So within that, we made the most of it, right? We pumped out just as many athletes as we actually have here. But due to financial stuff with the university, eventually my position and the salary was actually cut. So I had the opportunity at that moment to continue what I love to do or to choose an easier route. I chose this decision, or I decided to speak about this tonight because I know it applies to both sides of the spectrum. Those that just finished the hardest season, and this is kind of your celebratory time as a freshman, etc. Or seniors that are on the opposite side of the spectrum and have no idea in this entire world what you're going to do. My one word of advice is find something that you love to do. Shortly after my position was defunded there, I continued to stay on. I stayed on for another 6 months. It was probably the hardest 6 months in my entire life, financially, mentally, physically, etc. If anyone ever told you that they worked 90 hours a week for free, you would probably think they were crazy, right? But you better love it. You better love it. So in the midst of all this stuff going on, I called my mentor and, you know, I'm moaning and groaning, and
I was like, man, they're doing this, they're doing this, the culture is terrible, I don't really want to be here. And his advice, although really, really simple, changed my life and the rest of my career. He said, Carter, shut up. Just care. When you care, everything else is going to take care of itself. I went on meditating on it. Was kind of mad to start with, to be honest, because it's so simple, yet so challenging sometimes. It's easy to care about yourself, but not care about other people. It's easy to care when everything's going well, when you're winning, etc. It's really hard to care when you're losing. You can tell a coach cares by how well they execute the job. You can tell how much an athlete cares by how well they execute the job. Once you guys graduate and you go on and you're sitting behind the desk, your boss is going to be able to tell how much you care based on how well you execute what's being asked of you. Secondly, you better love it. You better love it, and the reason why I say that, and now I've told a couple of you guys this before, but love endures all things. I worked for 6 months, 90 hours a week, unpaid. Why? Because I love it, and I care about my student athletes. Sincerely. When your love outweighs how bad you want to stop, then you'll be successful. When your love for the game and your love for winning surpasses that daring condition when you're about to check your lunch out, then you'll be successful. With all that said, love what you do, care about what you do, and do everything to the best of your God-given ability. Everything. Okay? That's all I have. Yeah! I'm just kidding. I'm back. Oh, man. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Thanks, man. So, first ever Iron Lion Awards. You guys excited about that? No. Oh, man. You guys excited about that? Yeah. So, student athletes that are recognized for the Iron Lion Award have set themselves aside from their peers in displaying excellent attitude, effort, and attention to detail in the classroom, weight room, and in their designated sports. The award recipients have consistently displayed their phenomenal character, hard work, and dedication to Marcell University athletics and surpassed the goals that have been set before them while creating a new standard for those that follow. If I call your name, do me a favor, just stay where you are, but stand up until we're all the way down. Brindley Johnson. Corey Sanders. Lainey Monk. Alex Naran. Trevor Bailey. Cody Bruns. Kristen Gamp. Dawson Connell. Tanner Hodge. Dustin Ravis. Chad Sykes. Brian Smart. Ruben Trio. Scotty Lee. Isaiah Jones. Justin Shelton. Jackson Reed. David Marshall. Emily Novi. Porcelain Goldsboro. Zana Boyd. Maddie Gailey. Jahari Mitchell. Monroe Sanderson. Timmy Erdua. Tristan Rankin. Malik Laurent. Jake Watson. Noah Pittman. Landon Honeycutt, Jalen Ellis, Joe Ray Morrison, Kobe Haynes, Ty Snelson, Stephen Reed, Demeke Lamboni, TJ Skinner, Jackson Googe, Cameron Kratz, Ben Barter, Seth Brenham, Brendan Chapman, Wilkes Riggins, Jackson McLean, Jaden Hicks, RJ Miller, Anthony Flores, Scott Casagrande, Justin Torrance, Jordan Martinsdale, I believe she's also gone. Stephen Smith, Jameer Epps, Brayden Hawson, Zach Kerrigan, AJ Howland, Zach McMahon, Zach Martin, Ryan Sheehan, Paxton Wortman, Francis Villanova, Haven Bounds, Virginia Joy, Houston Faust, Maria Fabrizio, Marcel Bustalby, Caleb Byerly, Ethan Lee, Connor McConkey, Peter Plumman, Brendan Whalen, Isabel Busenbart, Deanna Bucket, Audrey Scoggins, Dave McDonald, Bailey Whitehead Press, Olivia Wilson, Julia Luna, Megan Blair, Sydney Craig, Deja Smith, Katie Todd, Mickey Maxson, Taylor Gallagher, Peyton Duda, Roman Pettit, James Nixon, Elspeth Roper, Xavier Gibbs Barger, Ferris Todd. Ferris, I'm not even going to try to say your last name, though. He's told me probably three times and I still have no idea. Chase Jorgensen, Amanda Kadiri, Inez Rodriguez, Levi Higgins, Lee Prescott, Jane Goodlett, Liam Mueller, Bailey Dinnan, Michaela Rogers, Caitlin Johnson, Jordan Schmucker, Jada Cannon, Grace Lilly, Nikki Stewart. Okay. Since there's a lot of you, and what's funny is the standard for this award is really high. It's really, really high. To be able to show exceptional attitude and effort and attention to detail on a consistent basis, that's not something a lot of people can do. I was speaking to a staff member earlier. I said, yeah, man, there's like 100 of them. I don't think we can do certificates for that many people. And they said, is it really that many people? I said, yes. We work in a phenomenal place, full of good people, good character people, and phenomenal student athletes. Within that, if you're currently standing over the summer, your name will be put up in the weight room, recognized as the first ever Iron Line Award winner. Two more. The next one is called the NSCA All-American Award. Although this was a tough decision, given the amount of phenomenal student athletes on campus, the following were nominated and awarded the honor of NSCA All-American by the National Strength and Conditioning Association. When I call your name, feel free to come on down. We actually have a little something for you. The male student athlete that was awarded the 2022 NSCA All-American Award displays exceptional attitude, effort, and attention to detail, both on and off the field. Although a majority of his achievements are statistically immeasurable given his position, he was the anchor of our offensive line, only allowing one sack, grading out in an 85.5 pass run, while starting the last 22 games straight. Even more so, he consistently shows the unique ability of pushing himself beyond breaking point, regardless of activity, for the sake of his brothers and our team's new goal. Thus, it is my great honor that I present Seth Brenham. Yeah! that was nominated for 2022 NSCA All-American Award also has displayed exceptional attitude, effort, and attention to detail on and off the mat. As a sophomore at Marshfield University, she currently holds a 3.92 GPA as a double major in criminal justice and psychology. In addition, at the end of the fall semester, she held a university relative back squat record for all female student athletes, squatting 1.65 times her body weight, while also being ranked second in relative bench press. More importantly, she's the definition of a servant leader and flexes her teammates before herself to ensure their team is moving forward towards their end goal. It's with my great honor and humility that I present Brantley Johnson with the 2022 MHU All-American Award. Attitude is your personal view of something, if you guys need a definition, an opinion or general feeling about something. Straight training, by its very nature, is extremely difficult. It requires a great deal of mental toughness and physical exertion to be effective. It is imperative that athletes and coaches come to train with a positive attitude and approach each day with purpose. Secondly, effort, energy. Mental or physical energy that is exerted in order to achieve a purpose. Straight training does not guarantee success, only the chance for success through diligent preparation. Three, details. Every element of the whole. Every element of the whole. All the individual parts fit together and make a whole. Attention to detail. Student athletes and teams that pay greatest attention to the subtle details of a workout, game plan, in the classroom, etc., are going to be most prepared to succeed. For the 2022 Iron Line Team Culture Award, if you want to, you can send down your team captains. Volleyball.
Good deck, student award recognized.
Lions athletes that came to Martinsville University and immediately made an impact to their team. Newcomer and freshman of the year honor student athletes that had an incredible first season on the Hill. Here to present female freshman of the year are Morgan Hall and Maggie Langheim.
The nominees are Amanda Kadiran, Alina Mueller, Victoria Chambers, Michaela Stewart, Cameron Miller, Maddie Gilly, and Colin Miller. And the winner of the female freshman of the year is Michaela Stewart.
Michaela Stewart, all South Atlantic Conference freshman team, 13th of the South Atlantic Conference in blocks per set, second freshman in that category, starting 24 matches for the Lions and a vital part of the team winning 21 matches, 7th in the South Atlantic Conference, 7th in the NCAA Southeast Regional Poll, first ever NCAA Regional Tournament bid, ladies and gentlemen, Michaela Stewart. Now to present the male freshman of the year, please welcome Bray Muskett and Maggie Langheim.
The nominees are Usopp, Lucas Nilsson, Kaden Dawkins, Patrick Mattson, Watson Stroud, Peter Coleman, Devontae Wilby Williams, and Christian Lane.
And the winner for male freshman of the year goes to
Devontae Wilby.
Devontae Wilby Williams, representing men's soccer, South Atlantic Conference, freshman of the year, all South Atlantic Conference second team. Scored 9 goals and added 7 assists for 25 points. This scored the Lions goal for the South Atlantic Conference championship. Ladies and gentlemen, Devontae Wilby Williams. And now to present and recognize the female newcomer of the year by Morgan Hall and Dalton Davidson.
The nominees are Brindley Johnson, Haley Stallings, and Emily Moore.
And the winner for female newcomer of the year goes to
Emily Novick.
She played 24 games, 15 starts, pulled out 68 rebounds, 28 steals, 24 assists, 8 blocks. So here we go, Emily Novick. And now to present male newcomer of the year, Virginia Joy and Blaine Tomaski.
The nominees are Isaiah Jones, Marquise Williams, and Dan Ross.
And the winner for the male newcomer of the year goes to
Marquise Williams.
Williams had 39 catches, 641 yards to the Lions, 5 touchdowns, that lead the Lions to the South Atlantic Conference championship game. I graduate student, Mr. Marquise Williams. And now, before we continue with the show, we'd like to honor postseason award director by our Lions this year. Statistical champion, Virginia Joy. Women's lacrosse, ground ball per game, 5.58. Women's lacrosse, ground ball per game, 22.40. Zach Berrigan, men's lacrosse, goals per game, 3.67. Matt Nagadoo, football, punt return average, 11.8 yards per game. Uli Martin, volleyball, dig percent, 6.28. And volleyball team, dig percent, 20.21. All South Florida Conference freshman team, representing Myers Hill, Ken Dawkins for men's basketball, Maddie Gilley, women's basketball, and Michaela Stewart for volleyball. All South Florida Conference third team, Sydney Joyce, women's lacrosse, Nick Kerrigan, men's lacrosse, Charlie Park, softball, Yana Cook, volleyball, Uli Martin, volleyball. All South Atlantic Conference second team representing the University of Colorado. Baseball, Kyle Jenkins, baseball. Justin Bullock, football. Peter Bowman, men's soccer. Devontae Willoughby-Williams, men's soccer. Donna Martinez, women's soccer. And Sarah Goddard, volleyball. All South Atlantic Conference first team representing the university include as follows: Zach Weaver, baseball; C.J. Thompson, football; Ty Seltzer, football; Kristen Rankin, football; Dexter Fitzpatrick, football; Landon Honeycutt, football; Sebastian Burles of men's soccer; Jeppe Christensen, men's soccer. South Atlantic Conference Freshman of the Year recognition go to Caden Dawkins, men's basketball; Devontae Willoughby-Williams, men's soccer; and Tristan Rankin, defensive freshman of the year for football. Let's give a round of applause to these outstanding performers throughout the 21-22 season. Our next two awards recognize athletes that have standout seasons and made a significant impact for their team. Athlete of the Year honors student athletes that had an incredible season here at the Hill. Please present to welcome to the stage our male athlete of the year. He's going to be presented by Morgan Hall. And you get it. All the details. Welcome back.
The nominees for Male Athlete of the Year are Marcos Martinez, Levi Higgins, Sebastian Burleson, Zach Berrigan, and Ty Smith.
The winner of Male Athlete of the Year is
Sebastian Burleson.
South Atlantic Conference first team selection, USC Southeast Region, D2CCA, all Southeastern Regional second team. Set a career high in every category this season, highlighted by his 12 goals, placing fourth in the South Atlantic Conference. His 30 points were second in the conference. The team captain led the Lions to the South Atlantic Conference championship game. Sebastian Burleson. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to present Female Athlete of the Year, please welcome back to the stage Maggie Langhain and Braden Hoskins.
The nominees for Female Athlete of the Year are Yelena Mackey, Elaine Monk, Lily Martin, Sane Martinson, and Sydney Joyce.
The winner of Female Athlete of the Year goes to
Lily Martin.
Julie Martin, Division II College Coaches Association All Region Second Team. American Volleyball Coaches Association Honorable Mention All Region. All South Atlantic Conference Third Team. 2020 and 2021 South Atlantic Conference Scholar Athlete of the Year. Led the South Atlantic Conference in digs and digs per set. Sixth of the nation for Division II. 5-year Dean's List member here at the University. 4 years, Carolina Conference Commissioners List. 2,425 career digs. Leader at Myersville. Dean was 7th in the SAC, 7th in the NCAA region rankings, and selected to the NCAA Regional Volleyball Tournament for the first time in program history. Big part of that, Billy Martin. This past year has been filled with fantastic games and performances. We have had several incredible individual accolades, but this award honors the most impressive outing of the entire season across all of our sports here at the university. Now to present the first team sports performance of the year award, Art Morgan Hall and Virginia Joy.
The winner of the first team sports performance of the year goes to Sarah Goddard, League Volleyball with 17 kills in the NCAA Regional Game versus
gentlemen, the big finale. Our next two awards recognize athletes that impacted Marysville University community on and off the field. The Man and Woman of the Year awards are awarded to those athletes that represent Marysville all around for athletics, academics, and involvement. Here to present the Man of the Year are Maggie Langheim and Virginia Troy.
The nominees for Man of the Year are Ruben Phillips, and Jimmy Aruba.
Yes, sir!
The winner of Man of the Year goes to Yepe Christensen.
Yepe Christensen represents men's soccer here at Marysville University. He was co-signed academic all-district first team, co-signed academic all-American first team, team captain, led the line to the first Southern Conference championship game since 1990. Yepe Christensen. Ladies and gentlemen, here to present our final award of the night, Woman of the Year, please welcome to the stage Dalton Davidson and Braden Hoskins.
The nominees for Woman of the Year are Alina Michelli, Elena Manta, Sarah Bowler, Tiana Tuckett, and Virginia Gray. And the winner of Woman of the Year goes to Sarah Bowler.
Sarah Bowler, a member of our volleyball program, graduated this spring with a 3.91 grade point average. She will graduate with honors. Psychology major, minors in coaching, women and gender studies, and a certificate in community engagement. Dean List every semester, 3-time Southern Conference Commissioner of Honor, SBA Vice President, Co-President of NAM, Student Ambassador, Father Scholar, Alpha Chi, First Year Mentor, 4-year Volleyball Player, Dean Nathan, NCAA, Southeast Richmond, First Time in Program History, she was the co-captain, Sarah Bowler.
That wraps up our awards for the evening. Congratulations to Sarah and all of our winners tonight. Just a reminder, winners, please stay afterwards for our post-event photos.
This is Zach's favorite night of the year, but it wouldn't be possible without some awesome people. We want to thank our advisors, Coach Giannis and Coach Smith.
Our director of athletics, Rick Baker.
Our media team, Adam Williams, Kirsten Dowse, Josh Matthews, Alexa Halloran, and Jordan Baker.
And everyone who helped us make this night possible.
Ladies. ladies and gentlemen, we want to send a very special thanks and congratulations to Coach Yannis on a wonderful coaching career here at Myersville University. She built a program that is today an outstanding one with recruits and best is still yet to come for those who brought in for the upcoming 2023 season. Coach Yannis recruited several all-South Atlantic Conference team members, led individuals in the team to be statistical champions in the league, and led the team to South Atlantic Conference tournament appearance in only their fourth season of existence. Her role as SAAC advisor cannot be understated for how much she has contributed not only to the SAAC, but to the growth of those involved with Lion Athletics. Congratulations, Coach Yannis, on your coaching accomplishments here at the Hill.
The student athlete advisory committee did an absolutely tremendous job at this event. I want to thank all the student athletes that are here tonight. This is why I do my job, because of you guys sitting in the seats. And what we saw here tonight just makes me reflect that I do have the best job in the world, like Coach Carter said. But I want you to know that I appreciate you too. I'm your biggest fan. I've got you at every home event. But we have great leadership with our administration and board of trustees. We've got great faculty and staff that support you. I can't be happier with the faces I'm seeing here tonight. But I want to thank these people here for putting on a great show. I want to thank Coach Yannis publicly for all the years of service that she's done. Thank you very much. And for all the work here tonight, I want to thank the guys up in the press box, because you don't realize a lot of times the hours that Adam and Josh and the interns put in, some of the other coaches that help us with game day operations. You don't realize a lot of times how many hours your coaches put in. You know, a lot of times everybody's gone home and the coaches are still looking at film. They're making recruiting calls. They're on the road recruiting. And a lot of times we went after the sacrifice of their family. So I want to thank my coaching staff. If all our coaches would please stand up quickly. Yeah. These guys really care about you, and they put in a lot of work for you to be successful, not only on the field, but off the field, and get your degree. So I just want to thank our coaches. I would like to thank everybody for being here. You know, Craig Oakford sitting in here. Denny Matthews, you know, Cindy Witt. I can go on and on. Daryl Morton, Stacey Allen. I mean, all these people, they show up, they volunteer, they support. Danielle and the spirit team does a great job cheering on all our athletes. I know I'm going to leave somebody out, so I apologize if I do. But I did want to give you a heartfelt thank you for being here tonight and all that you do. And I know this is a tough time of the semester, so bear down on the academics and make sure you finish strong. And we have a great summer. We work hard over the summer. We come in here next fall and spring and start winning some South Atlantic Conference championships. Thank you.
Thank you all for joining us to recognize our
student athletes. Have a great night, everyone. So-called flying off.
I am here to discuss so-called flying saucers.